It's time for the announcement of this year's induction class into the 2022 Bayou Region Athletic Hall of Fame. We're proud to announce our 6 inductees and look forward to the opportunity to celebrate their history throughout the year in our Bayou region. So without further ado, here they are in alphabetical order by last name. Our first inductee is LaRose High School graduate Bob Brunet. Brunet went on from Bayou Lafourche to star at Louisiana Tech, where he was an all-Gulf States Conference running back in the mid-60s. He was drafted by the Washington Redskins in the 7th round of the 1968 draft and ran for over 250 yards in his rookie year. In 1970, he was voted as the special teams MVP in the NFL. He enjoyed 9 years in the league and was known to be a coaching favorite of legends Vince Lombardi and George Allen. Brunet and his family now live in Denham Springs. Our next inductee is also a LaRose native. Art Cantrell moved on from the Bayou region to play his last year of high school football in Biloxi. After that, he came back to his home state, where he became an all-SEC running back for LSU. Cantrell ran for over 1,600 yards as a Tiger and played in both the Orange and Sun Bowls. After collegiate football, he went on to have a productive pro career, where he was part of the 1973 Grey Cup Championship team Ottawa Rough Riders in the CFL, and the WFL champion Birmingham Americans in 1974. Cantrell now resides in Biloxi. Joining those two will be local coaching legend Kenneth Dixon. Originally from Bunky, Louisiana, Coach Dixon lived most of his life in the Bayou region, where he was the leader in the success of girls basketball in our area. In his tenure at Ellendale Memorial High School since 1992, he led the Lady Patriots to 5 state championship titles, 2 state runner-up finishes, and 12 district titles. He accumulated over 650 career wins, and maybe most importantly, paved the way for over 20 young ladies to play collegiate basketball. Coach Dixon unexpectedly passed away of health issues during the high school playoffs last season. Our fourth inductee, Leonard Hughes, joins the class by virtue of his stellar career in NHRA racing for his part on the legendary Candies and Hughes racing team. Initially a driver for the team, he later went on to perform mechanic and tuning duties for the world champion drag racing team. In 1968, the Homer native and his crew set the national strip record with a speed of 7.87 seconds on the quarter-mile track at the U.S. Nationals, then reset the record at 7.60 seconds in 1969. Hughes and his wife Judy continued to live in Houma. Troy Johnson, our next inductee, was a standout track and field athlete at both South Terrebonne High School and Southern University, which led to a 6-year professional football career as a wide receiver. After his stint at Southern, Johnson became a leading receiver for the Denver Gold of the USFL in the mid-80s. When the league folded, he played for 4 more years in the NFL, with his most productive years coming with the Cardinals, where he had over 550 yards receiving in 2 years. He went on to play for the Steelers and the Lions to round out his career. Troy and his family live in Houma. And our final inductee is Thibodaux High graduate Thomas Roussel. A stellar all-conference linebacker for the Eagles of the University of Southern Mississippi, Roussel played in both the Senior Bowl and the Blue-Gray Bowl, where he was the defensive MVP after his senior year. In 1968, he was drafted by the Washington Redskins in the 2nd round. He played in every Redskins game for the next 2 years before being traded to the Saints for Billy Kilmer. Roussel played for 2 years with the Saints before moving on to the WFL with the Chicago Fire. He and his family now live in Covington. And there you have it, the 6 greats who will be inducted into the class of 2022's Bayou Region Athletic Hall of Fame. Bob Brunet, Art Cantrell, Kenneth Dixon, Leonard Hughes, Troy Johnson, and Thomas Roussel. What a class! We'll have more history to share on each of our inductees as we lead up to the induction ceremony in June.